distributed entanglement is just a basis for quantum networks, which will connect quantum computers in the future in a similar way like the internet does with current computers. The basis for this is entanglement between two positions. And in our experiment, we distributed this between a lab in Schellingstraße and one in Schackstraße, and the fiber connecting the two of them, it just crosses the street below the two fountains here.
The fiber connecting the two laboratories goes through this corridor over here, and then halfway the corridor goes out towards the fountains. We have two labs. We're standing here next to lab one, and we have another lab at the other side of the campus, lab two. And what we do is we two times generate atom-photon entanglement. We send the photons to a middle station. There we do a measurement on the photons, and then we can entangle the two atoms. And we do experiments where we try to implement secure communication protocols, or what we're also trying to do is increase the distance between the two laboratories.
Quantum information provides us with a lot of new tools for computation and also for communication. So for computation, you know that the quantum computer can solve certain tasks in a different way and then much, much faster than any classical computer could do. And in communication, we can provide you with really secure communication, such that you know about the maximum information what an eavesdropper could have about the key what we generate. To ensure this, we now implemented a new protocol, a so-called device-independent protocol, which really makes sure of this.
We trap single rubidium atoms here, and we use those atoms to do quantum information experiments. So what we do is we use lasers to first optically cool the atom, and then we can store one atom in the focus of an, we call it an optical dipole trap laser. What we can do is we can entangle the polarization of a photon that is emitted by this atom with the spin state of the atom. Then we collect the photon with a high NA objective, and we can send this photon through long optical fibers to other places.
Now we also demonstrated that it is possible to make this fiber which connects Schellingstraße and Schackstraße now much, much longer. And to do this, we implemented in this fiber connection another 30 kilometers of fiber, such that it really would be useful for future quantum networks, for example, connecting quantum computers one day. We cannot do both at the same time because the noise is still somewhat too high, but in the future, the quality of this entanglement distribution will be better, and then you can do everything at the same time.